How does this relate to our calculations we're going to do this semester? So here we have two good examples of when do we use atoms versus when do we use molecules or particles. So if we take a look, we say we have 6.022 times 10 to the 23 atoms of iron. Iron is there by itself, so that's why we're using the term atoms. And remember, that's Avogadro's number. That number is always equal to 1 mole of whatever we're talking about. So since we have this many atoms of iron, that means we have 1 mole of iron. We're going to say also that 1 mole of something is related to its weight, its atomic mass, which you'll find on your periodic table. So if you look at your periodic table right now, look for iron. It's a transition metal. So 1 mole of iron is equal to its atomic mass that you see on your periodic table. And if you take a look, you'll see 55.85. Okay. So that's representative of its atomic mass unit, or we can say 55.85 grams per mole. What we need to realize here is that there's a connection. We can go from atoms to moles to grams. And I show you double arrows, meaning we can go either way. So we can go from atoms to moles or moles to atoms. We can go from moles to grams or grams to moles. The arrows go both ways. And what we should realize here is that moles play the connection that's between atoms and grams. So remember, you can't go straight from atoms to grams without having first go through moles.